model code of conduct for elections is applicable to media that is print, electronic as well as social media. Social media is not exempted. Since social media is also a part of the media which disseminates information, it can't be exempted. It is a part of the media only. So this model code of conduct is applicable to social media also. See, in my capacity as journalist, I have been covering elections for the past 27 years, that is 1991. So I have covered many elections, both Lok Sabha and Vidhan Sabha. So this model, social media was not prevalent in those days, early 90s. It has only become a buzzword for the past 10-15 years. So it's a new challenge. But the Election Commission has clarified that the social media's task is to disseminate information. That means it is a part of the media. You call it social media, but it's a part of the media. So election model code of conduct is applicable to social media also. Whatever the restrictions that are made for print media and electronic media, it is applicable to the social media also. It is applicable, to the best of my knowledge, it is applicable to the groups or the political parties which form groups or pro-political party groups that would. Individually, if I want to send it to my friends in favor of any for a political party, I am not exempted. I'm not controlled by that. So, a group that is formed by a political party, if it is operating in batting for a political for this particular party or that political party, they come under this model code of conduct. For individuals, it is not. It's like curbing the fundamental right. So individuals can do it. See, model code of conduct is applicable to all political parties and all independent candidates. A candidate may be independent, he doesn't have any political party, but still that model code of conduct is applicable to him. For example, it applies to individual candidate also, irrespective of whether he belongs to a political party or not. Independent candidate means he doesn't belong to any political party. This is made, for example, in this model code of conduct, the ceiling for spending the money in elections for assembly is 28 lakhs. It is applicable to political parties also. It is applicable to individuals also, independent candidates also, number one. Number two, there is a restriction, there is a regulation in the number of booth agents to be appointed, number of people who sit as counting agents. So whatever is applicable to political parties is applicable to the independents also. These are some of the, and the public meetings that are addressed by political party leaders, it cannot go beyond 6 p.m. in the evening. Okay, and that is applicable to the independent candidate also. So anybody who contests the elections, they come under the Representatives of People's Act as under the definition of election, defined by Election Commission, and whatever that is model code of conduct that is evolved by the Election Commission, which is applicable to political parties, is applicable to independent candidates also. The state governments doesn't have any right to announce new programs, number one. Number two, whatever the regular day-to-day administration of the state government, that has to take place, number two. Number three, the people will be affected in the sense that the officials who will be working in the state government at different levels are all drawn for election work. So the people's day-to-day work will definitely suffer, like issuing birth certificate, like issuing death certificate, like issuing khata for farmers, like issuing encumbrance certificates. So these things will get delayed because the officials are drawn for election work. So once the Election Commission announces the dates of the elections and model code of conduct comes into being, all state governments, including police officials, including police, are under the jurisdiction of the Election Commission. So regular, normal day-to-day activities will have to take place, but there might be some delay also, because of which people will be put into trouble. But it is inevitable. You can't escape from this. It's a part of the democratic process.